want to spend my life mending broken people. I want to spend my life removing pain. Lord, let my words heal a heart that hurts. I want to spend my life mending broken people. I want to spend my life mending broken people.
Hello and welcome to Trivian Today. This is a wonderful opportunity for you and us to learn wonderful things about a ministry that God is using to bring light and also hope.
Amen. And
so, my name is John Dinzey. My wife, Idalia, is with me, and we are just praising the Lord for His goodness.
Amen. And His faithfulness, too.
Amen.
You know, during this hour, we are going to be blessed. We're going to hear testimonies, and we're going to see how the Lord has led in the ministry. Sometimes we ask, what can I do for the Lord? And sometimes the Lord calls us and shows us a way, and we're like, no, that is really not me. But it's the Lord's calling, right? So we're going to hear testimony about how the Lord has led the director of this ministry and his lovely wife into ministry.
That's right.
And this is an ministry that is impacting lives individually and personally. Mm-hmm. And it's a life of sacrifice, but it's a life of pure joy because we're serving the Lord. We are Jesus' hands and feet here on earth, right?
That's right. That's right. You know, I've heard somebody say, you may be the only Jesus that somebody will ever see or hear.
Mm-hmm.
So it's interesting because we get to be a light for others.
Amen.
We want to welcome our guests that are here with us, and Rolando Porras and his wife Emily. Welcome, Rolando.
Thank you, John. Thank you, Idalia. It's a pleasure to be here.
Amen.
And Emily, thank you for being here.
Thank you.
Yes. It's exciting to see couples in ministry.
That's right. That's right.
It's a team.
Amen. Amen. Well, the name of the ministry is Choose Life Abundant. Mm-hmm. Choose Life Abundant. And this is a ministry that, as we said before, God is using. And we think that you will be blessed as you hear what they are doing.
Mm-hmm.
But you also get to hear testimonies from people that have been there. And it's just a joy to know that the testimonies bring you excitement and hope, and you just say, praise the Lord.
Well, just like the name it says, choose life
choose
abundant.
Life. Mm-hmm.
Choose to enjoy this hour.
That's right.
Choose to listen and choose to ask the Lord, Lord, where do you want me to go? What do you want me to do? Don't ever forget that the Lord has made provision for every single need that His children have in this planet Earth. But we also stand in the promise that my God shall provide supply every need according to His purpose. So during this hour, we're going to share testimonies, but also we're going to pray with you.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to just hold you in the altar, present you to the Lord, because you know your needs. And sometimes we don't even know our own needs. So we just pray that the Lord will reveal what your needs are and lead you in your life for decisions.
Amen. Amen.
To choose life.
Amen. We now invite you to join us in prayer.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to the Lord in prayer, and we'd like to ask you, Dalia, if you'll pray for us.
Oh, okay. Father God, we just come before your throne of grace with cheerful hearts, thankful, Lord, for your goodness and your mercy. Thank you for guiding and directing our thoughts, our feet, Lord. We ask you to be with us. We actually thank you for being with us because you're always with us. We're never alone. Father, as we share about Choose Life Abundant Ministry, there are folks listening and watching this program who have a need. I pray that you will reveal their need and you will guide them to make a choice for life. For you have come to give us life and life more abundant. Mm-hmm. So I pray, Father, not just for this ministry, but all the ministries that are holding you high and drawing all men to you. I pray, Father, for every viewer, every listener. You know their challenges, you know their victories, you know their dreams and their goals. May your peace be with them. And as they contemplate your goodness in this ministry, that they will be encouraged to see your goodness in their lives too. Amen. In Jesus' name we pray and we thank you. Amen.
Yeah, amen. 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 Praise the Lord. Well, at this time, we're going to scripture, Jeremiah chapter 29, verse 11, a beautiful promise from the Lord.
Yeah, many people don't even need to read it because it's so common. Mm. It's a very well-known Bible text.
Mm-hmm. That's right. Would you like to read it for us?
Yes, I will read it. For I know the thoughts that I have toward you, says the Lord, thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you an expected end. So this is the version, Jeremiah 29:11.
Amen. Thank you very much. Mm. Well, do you have anything you would like to share about this verse and why it might be special to you?
Absolutely. Being called by God can be a terrible thing. but it's a terrific thing.
Amen.
When you take the step.
Yes.
Oftentimes, fear can get in the way. And that's why I said that at the beginning.
Mm-hmm.
And when he called me to go in this journey, it was a very difficult decision because I had a life that was set up. I was a financial advisor. Everything was working really well. I had a steady life, if you may, a good salary. And the Lord calls me to this work with no salary, no network, no, you know, it was a very different path.
Mm-hmm.
And I felt through a little bit of anxiety. I wouldn't say a little bit. I actually got big time in anxiety.
Mm-hmm.
And it fell into depression a little bit too.
Mm, wow.
And only when I said, yes, Lord, I'll take the call. Mm-hmm. I'll answer to your call.
Wow.
Everything changed for me.
Amen.
Everything changed. And I realized that what I thought was special, the places where I would find joy, were very, very small in comparison to the joy that I was finding
Amen.
In serving God and His people.
Amen.
Serving Jesus in the body of His people.
Amen.
And
Amen.
So I realized when God calls,
mm-hmm.
He's got a special plan for each one. All we got to do is have the right, you know, take the right step. Take
yes.
the step forward, if you may.
Take a faith.
That's mm-hmm. right.
Amen. Mm-hmm. Amen.
Yes. Trust in the Lord with all your heart.
Yes.
And with all your mind, soul.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You know, the scripture has good news.
Yes.
It's not that God is saying, well, I really don't know what to do. I have no idea what we're going to do for you. Mm-hmm. But Emily, God says He knows the plans. What do you think about that?
I would fully agree with that. I think that in my experience, just in the last couple of years, I ended up in a place that I never expected to because I said to God, I want your will.
Amen.
And I want to do whatever you have for me.
Mm-hmm.
And I unexpectedly, very unexpectedly,
how the Lord leads,
was led into this ministry.
Amen.
Through meeting Rolando.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that I would agree that God knew all along the hope and the future that He had planned
yes.
for me.
Amen.
When I could never have imagined it,
mm-hmm.
but it's better than what I would have chosen for myself, for
Praise
sure.
God. Praise
Amen.
God.
Praise the Lord.
All good things come from above.
Amen.
And
That's
the
every
Lord
good gift.
Works. Yes.
My favorite.
Every good gift. It is?
Yeah, one of my favorite verses.
Amen. 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 Mine too. We have to remember that, you know, sometimes we take for granted mm-hmm. all those wonderful gifts. And if we pause and contemplate how things happen or are orchestrated on our behalf, well, you can't doubt the power of God. He chooses, He calls, but He equips.
That's
so
right.
So here you are in your journey.
Yeah.
You had your financial guru job, and you just had all these plans, and all of a sudden, the Lord calls you out of comfort.
Mm-hmm.
And you're like, oh, no, I'm okay here. It can't be the Lord telling me this. I studied all this. Look where I'm at. Why would I start all over?
Yeah.
But the Lord called you. Mm. How do you, can you identify that it is the Lord's call?
Yeah.
You know?
It's a process of there's a lot of fleeces that I threw out there. And I just,
Amen.
I surrendered and I said, Lord, if this is what you're calling me to, mm-hmm.
yes.
I need you to show me.
Amen.
I need you to close the doors
yes.
of where I am mm-hmm. and open the doors for where you're calling me to.
Amen.
Because I'm willing to take the step if you can just show me.
Amen. Amen.
And so when I did that, he definitely closed a career of 22 years in the financial industry.
Wow.
As vice president of private bank. And so, yes. you know, when he did that,
yes.
The call was, okay, you're ready?
That's
you're ready?
Right.
And I'm thinking, I knew I had, you know, to make a decision because time was running out and people
right.
were calling from other banks saying, we would like to hire you.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. Same position, vice president.
Right.
And the, you know, the offerings were great.
Yes.
The and offers. The Lord kept you know, mm-hmm. closing those doors.
Amen.
But there's a moment where you have to make that decision.
That's true.
And you back it up with what he's telling you through the scriptures.
Amen.
So it's a combination of, Lord, close the door, mm-hmm. and he'll explain that to you later through
yes.
the verses.
Yes.
Praise yeah. God. Mm-hmm. Praise God.
You know how many people are going through this journey right now
yeah.
that are questioning if the Lord is truly calling them into ministry? Mm-hmm. So that is encouraging to know that you put out fleas mm-hmm. and you asked the Lord to close the doors. Mm-hmm. You were willing to walk that road until the Lord says, turn right, turn left. This is the place that I have for you. And that's how the Lord does for you and for me. And all we need to do is trust God. And if he calls, he will equip us.
That's
and
right.
you're a great team. Wow. I'm excited about today's interview.
Amen. Huh? Amen. Well, before we continue, we'd like to present to you a musical offering. Mm-hmm. And we have Jared and Hillary Mitchell, and they are going to interpret the prayer.
Remember, we are
another soul to love.
Another soul to love. Let this be our prayer.
Just like every child.
Just like every child
needs to find a place. Guide us with your grace. Give us faith so we'll be saved. Needs to find a place. Guide us with your grace.
Thank you, Jared and Hillary Mitchell, and the song, The Prayer. If you would like to get in touch with them, you may get in touch with us, or you can find them on Facebook. And we are praising the Lord because we're going to hear some more good news. Yeah. Rolando and Emily are here from Choose Life Abundant. And you told us how the Lord called you, but how did you get started? I mean, you had the calling of the Lord. And you had some moments where you even got depressed, wondering if this is the Lord's will. How did you get started?
Well, there's a little bit of a backstory. Mm-hmm. While I was in finance, I was working full time, mm-hmm. but I dedicated one day a week to set up a center of influence in my community.
Oh, good.
So yeah, I would invite our visitors to say, our community, come yes. and check your vitals with us. If you want to learn to live like the blue zones, we have the key, the mm-hmm. secrets for that. Mm-hmm. And so people were very curious. They start coming in, and I did that for 5 years.
5 years?
5 years.
Once a week.
Once a week.
Wow.
So Idalia, absolutely. And if you would have called me, I would have said, Idalia, the next opening is in 10 months.
Wow.
It was that busy.
Wow.
Tremendous.
Very, very much, yeah. So that was 5 years working for free. 2019, my job closes.
Yes.
For some legal reasons, it all came to an end.
Yeah.
And then that's when the Lord says, let's go big. Mm. So I, you know, in my work, I would send people to other sanatoriums. But I noticed that there's a lack in certain things. Mm. So when the Lord called me to do this, I said, okay, how does this even look like?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
So I grab a pen and paper and I drew a business plan mm-hmm. because I'm a business background.
That's yes. right.
And I also drew a picture of what sanatorium should look like.
Oh.
So I had a sanatorium A and a sanatorium B. Mm-hmm. Sanatorium A was multi-million. Sanatorium B was a small sanatorium. Mm-hmm. And I started thinking, if I need to get this going, I need to start moving.
Yes.
So I started looking up places where I can set this up prayerfully. Everything has Amen. Been done prayerfully.
Amen.
So I ended up in Colorado, mm-hmm. North Carolina,
wow.
Kentucky, mm-hmm. Alabama, wow. and Tennessee. Cool. 50 properties later.
50 properties later.
Yes, 50 properties later.
Okay.
I had people that wanted to back me up financially, but they backed out. So Ooh. I was left with plan B, a small mm-hmm. sanatorium.
Yes.
So the Lord led me to this sanatorium, which we call Choose Life Abundant. That's where we...
Oh, it's beautiful. Look at that image.
Yeah, that's an aerial view. And that property was not available when I went to Tennessee. That property was under contract.
Mm-hmm. What's this here?
So that's the greenhouse there where we plant some of our food. Mm-hmm. And that's the master bedroom where we
Beautiful.
Like to keep our guests or have that for our guests. That's the second bedroom for our guests.
Nice.
And that's where we teach. That's the living area. That's our office where we do the health assessments.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Beautiful out in the country.
So, yeah.
It's great.
The interesting thing about it was when we set it up, mm-hmm. it was a month before COVID.
Oh,
I did not know that.
Oh, wow.
So here I am bringing everything that I have,
yes.
my savings, retirement account,
yes.
disconnecting from my network, moving houses, buying a new property, mm-hmm. setting this thing up, and then COVID comes in. Uh-uh. And so that's when I said, Lord, if you want this to work,
there
needs to be a miracle. And he faithfully kept bringing people once a month, or, you know, if he didn't do that, if he didn't send someone 1 month, he would back it up with two people the next.
Oh, amen.
And so through COVID, where everything was locking down,
right,
the Lord keeps sending people.
Wow.
And that's how we have survived. With no salary, the Lord has covered it. We're a nonprofit, but he has kept us alive.
Amen. So what did those people go to you for?
So typically the phone call looks like this.
Yes.
Hey, I'm struggling with my thyroid, or I am dealing with weight management, or, you know, I have these other ailments. Now, we do know that 9 out of 10 diseases originate in the mind. So in our ministry, we're very heavy with, let's take a look at the mental health.
Yes.
And oftentimes, I would say the number is right. It's 90% of the times we do find that people that come to our work, it's not just a thyroid issue. There's so much more at the root level. See, the thyroid is only a fruit issue.
It's the tip of the iceberg, you might say.
That's correct. And you can prune all you like.
Yes.
But if you don't address the roots, you're going to be stuck in this cycle. And so that's how we got started with, let's explore the mind. Let's focus on what is at the root level. Because at the root level, my friends, we all have the same issues. Maybe loneliness, maybe unworthiness, rejection, betrayal. So we can address those safely through the Bible.
Through the Bible.
Through the Bible.
Very good. So you had 6 Bible studies going on a week. How did you manage all that time?
That's right.
And precious Emily is waiting on you. You're doing these Bible studies, or you guys are doing it together.
That's true. So, you know, back in the day in Florida, where we were first based, when I was a banker, my desire was to, how do I share this truth with people? And in the business field that I, well, where I was working at, I had a lot of Ivy League people that I worked with. And so my desire was to bring the good news to the wealthy, well-educated. And you know, and so it was a little hard for me to establish a meeting with them because they would say, yes, I'd like to meet with you, but they wouldn't show up for that. So I pleaded with Lord. I said, Lord, what is it that I'm doing wrong? You see my desire to share.
Right.
Please share what I'm doing wrong.
Right.
Yes.
And the Lord said, let me show you a different route. It was through the health message.
Amen.
And so that's how the ministry got started back in 2015.
Wow.
And now people were saying, why are you doing this for free? Why are you taking care of my situation? Why are you coming to my house and teaching me how to cook?
Wow.
Why are you visiting the neighbor and helping this and so forth? Now they're starting to get really interested and I'm discovering their needs. And by discovering their needs and offering solutions, the next thing you know is, tell me more about yourself. And if you have that desire, that zeal for God, it's going to come out.
Right.
And now they're curious about, who is this God?
Yes.
And before you know it, we had a Bible study on Mondays, Tuesdays, every day of the week.
Wow. Yeah. Amen.
Tremendous.
So I was burning out so many Bible studies, if you may. Yeah.
So Lawrenceburg, Tennessee, I mean, you saw so many properties. What made this place special to you that you said, this is the place?
Yeah. When I drew that drawing of that business plan.
Plan A, Plan B.
Plan B. The drawing was there, a little house with another little building on the side, some trees lined up in a way and a driveway that way. I'm telling you those details for a reason. Because that was the drawing. And when I went to the place, it was exactly like that.
Praise God.
So I knew. I knew that there's something about this. Yeah. The Lord was saying, go forward. And that's how I knew.
Emily, what's your background? I mean, he was talking about Florida, Miami, and places like this, but now this is country. How was that for you?
Well, I've grown up most of my life in small town or country.
Oh, okay.
So it was something that I already loved. My background, career-wise, was in elementary education.
Amen.
So I had grown up in the Adventist church, and I went to Adventist schools, and I had read about God's plan for education, and I wasn't sure I wanted to be a teacher, but I ended up pursuing that path, and eventually, over the years, came to a point where I accepted, yes, I'm a teacher, and I felt like, almost like where Rolando was at, like this, not a pinnacle of success, but I felt like had skill. I knew what I was doing. I was happy.
Enjoying.
I was enjoying it. Mm-hmm. Yeah, fully. I had a good collaboration with colleagues, and I was loving it. And then God said, okay, now it's time to learn something new.
Wow.
I want to take you further in and further up, I guess, is a way to say it. Mm-hmm. And there are areas here that I've seen in my character that I see need polishing that I couldn't see in that field. Well, I could see it at the beginning of my time in elementary education, and I feel like I was able to grow in a lot of areas, but now here, I'm like back to the drawing board.
So. But the Lord is holding the drawing pencil, right?
He is, exactly.
And he brings the brightness to your life.
Exactly.
And you know, it takes a special person to be able to teach elementary. So that was your training for for ministry, because we adults can be even worse than kids at times.
I know. Yes.
Because we don't want to eat our vegetables, and we're old enough to say no, right?
Right. That's right. But God is good. God is good to prepare. And I know that even though I was maybe ready for the beauty of the country, there were areas that I wasn't very skilled or happy in, like in the kitchen, for instance. Mm-hmm. And here now we're preparing food for whoever comes. Wonderful. And whatever their needs are. Mm-hmm. And God had been preparing me with friends in my life helping me, and then Rolando helping me here. And so bit by bit, he's drawing that picture, he's like, here's the next little step.
Amen, amen. I saw some fabulous pictures of the meals you prepare. So you have a lot to offer, Rolando and Emily. So tell us more about this sanitarium.
Well, we can't take credit for all those good things. It really is the Lord has capacitated us to do this work. In terms of those meals, we cater to different dietary restrictions. So if someone calls me and says, well, I have these symptoms, maybe autoimmune situation, then we have to go with a protocol that is autoimmune diet. Mm-hmm. If the person has diabetes, a different diet. Mm-hmm. But the baseline of it comes from a diet that a man by the name Peter Karstens, and I think it's been at your program before.
Yes, yes. Mm-hmm.
So we use the corrective diet. So I learned that from him.
Excellent.
That's the foundation.
Yes.
And so, you know, we always tell our visitors, a good diet is important.
Yes.
You are what you eat. Mm-hmm. However, we waste a lot of the benefits. And I've seen numbers as high as 75% of wasted benefits when we don't combine a diet with exercise. Mm-hmm. So if you combine that, you get the whole full reward.
Yes, yes. So tell me, you mentioned Peter Karstens, and we know of his ministry that he had funded, he was the founder of his ministry. Yes. And we hear of so many sanitariums or lifestyle centers. Mm-hmm. Tell us, what is so different about yours? Because some folk at home, don't tell me another lifestyle center, Idalia. What's so special about this one? Well, they're all special and unique in their own ways. Mm-hmm. So praise the Lord that you have been studying and learning and teaching, and you see changes in people's lives. So tell us, what's so special about your sanitarium?
Yes. So there's the idea to set up a sanatorium is not an easy thing to do.
No.
But when I started visiting other sanatoriums, I started discovering their best practices, what worked there.
Yes.
And I'm a financial analyst by nature, so I pick the best, you know, as I would do with stocks.
Amen.
And I look at their fundamentals, and I like this company, so I'm going to, you know, invest in this one. And I did that. I picked up the best practices of the many sanatoriums that were very successful. And what I did is I put them together.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And one thing I've noticed was that, again, every sanatorium has a strength. I noticed that mental health was a room for improvement. Mm-hmm. And so what I've discovered is through trainings that I've done and, you know, furthering my education, was to start addressing the mental health component.
Okay.
And so that was very key for us. Mm-hmm. Because again, a lot of people come in and at the end of the program, they tell me, I didn't realize I had so much baggage.
Okay, I have a question for you. Now, we will see some pictures in all of your facility, and we'll hear some testimonies. But is this just for adults? The mental challenges. I'm assuming you, as a teacher who have worked with children, have you spotted that? I'm assuming that nowadays is even more pronounced. Tell us about that.
Yeah, for sure. And I think I started seeing that, you know, in the classroom. And I almost pursued occupational therapy because I felt like, man, there's so much that these kids need that I'm not able to do,
right,
you know, as a classroom teacher. Mm-hmm. Issues with, you know, kids that have suffered from abuse, you know, other traumas in their life.
Emotional trauma.
Yeah, absolutely. Mm-hmm. And so when I came with Rolando here, we started talking, and this was something that was on his heart, like, before he met me, too. Like, how can we reach the children? How can
yes.
we reach the youth?
The whole family.
Exactly, the whole family mm-hmm. together.
Yes.
And so we've been developing a program so that way I can work with the youth as he's working with the adults in tandem, together mm-hmm. as families.
Good.
And, yeah, we're really excited.
That's wonderful.
About
excellent.
That.
So your ministry, their ministry gives the chance for the whole family.
Absolutely.
To
mm-hmm. One of the things one of the talents that I appreciate about Emily is that she has the ability to grab that material and bring it down to the level of an 8-year-old, maybe a 13-year-old.
Wonderful.
So she has that ability to design unit plans and bring this the science and, you know, interactive practices
yes.
so that it can be cemented in the heart.
Mm-hmm. So the Lord has done a good work putting you two together. Then.
Absolutely. Even our, you know, getting together is a miracle.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Walk us through your facility. What services do you offer? I believe we have some pictures of your
yes.
your gym and something else.
Absolutely. We do have
this looks hydrotherapy. Beautiful. Hydrotherapy.
Yes. So we throw some ice on those tanks that are at the back.
Okay.
Those metallic tanks. So we get people coming in the hot for 4 minutes, then into the cold tanks. And again, this is not for everyone because
right.
there might be some contraindicators, but we are very careful in monitoring everyone's case.
Nice.
We also do that at the gym. You see there's two screens on there.
Yes.
So we equip our visitors with holsters. A holster is one of those heart rates that you put on the
okay.
on the chest.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Excellent.
And so depending on your age, we can see whether you're exceeding yourself or not. So we can tell people, hey, we can slow down here. You know,
mm-hmm.
that's the kitchen.
What?
So
your kitchen.
That's where a lot of happiness happens. You know,
I see your smiles. A lot of love.
Yeah. We love like to that. Cook. We love to eat. And we know that that's very important. So
yes.
every meal is a cooking class. Mm. We get our visitors involved.
Oh, well, wow. That looks delicious there.
This that's, is vegan? Yeah.
We're sorry,
that's all
people
vegan.
On radio
how can vegan food look so good? Wonderful.
Yeah. Yeah. So part of this is teaching people how to prepare nutritious, healthy meals.
Absolutely. And we want to equip them so that they when they go home, they know how to cook it.
Yes.
Versus, hey, what's the recipe again?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And it could be that they're eating a lot of the good foods, but not at the right time.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sure you teach them how to schedule or how to prepare their meals, meal planning at their homes? Or
absolutely.
What do you do?
Yes. So, again, every dietary restriction is a little different. But what we do is we equip them with the foundational principles.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And so we teach when to, because it's not only what you eat, it's how you eat it.
Yes.
Yes.
What good is it to eat something when your anxiety levels are up through the roof? You're not going to digest that properly.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And so we got to give our bodies time to not only absorb, but to also pause and rest, and also to detoxify, which sometimes we interrupt by adding snacks.
Mm. Oh.
You know, it's interesting, you know, how to eat, because I think we get accustomed to eating really fast. I remember a sergeant saying one time to the soldiers, if you can taste your food, you're wrong.
Wow.
So
training.
You, yes, it takes training.
Mm-hmm.
People are always in a hurry.
Yes.
So the making the food is part of the program that you do. Mm-hmm. How long is a session or a program for the people that come in?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we have two kinds of programs. We have a 5-day express, and then we have a 10-day program, which is what we really like to work with.
Mm-hmm.
The reason why we like that is because we want to earn your trust.
Mm-hmm.
And so we want to be safe people for one reason, for you to start opening up those roots.
Oh, that's because right.
Because if we don't open those roots, we
right.
can't work them.
Yes. That's right.
We must identify the problem. God has given us a wonderful blueprint,
mm-hmm.
the journey of Exodus.
Yes.
And so you start at what keeps you trapped.
Mm-hmm.
What are you a slave of?
Mm-hmm.
do you want to stay there? And you've seen how that looks. Or do you want to take a step out of your comfort zone? Because nobody grows in their comfort zones. Mm-hmm. And in that journey from Exodus, the trappings, mm-hmm. to liberty, to Mount Amen. Sinai, Amen. You get all the loss of health.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And notice also, mm-hmm. the Lord speaks to us in Mount Sinai.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
He reveals truth. Mm-hmm. Yes. And that counters our cognitive distortions. Again, mm-hmm. now we're addressing mental health again.
That's right.
Okay.
You see that process?
Mm-hmm. Excellent.
So those two, the 10-day program we like better for those reasons. It's more profound, and it also includes cleanses.
Mm-hmm. And so, go ahead.
Have you had people do the 5-day and say, I'm going to come back for the 10-day? Have you had that happen?
Yes, we have. Yeah. In fact, my favorite story happened in a 5-day program. Mm-hmm. I had two young men. One of them, I didn't realize he wasn't as interested in Christianity. In fact, he was more of an agnostic.
Okay.
And halfway the program, he pulls me aside and says, I'm not really interested in the spiritual part of your program.
Mm. Oh.
And that caught me by surprise because, you know, I had thought that he was coming in for that and his friend or his relative. So I said, well, let me ask you this. I learned this at another wellness center. So I asked them, do you have a belief system that you abide to? Yes, I do. Are you, how deep are you in those beliefs? Well, I'm very cemented in those. So I said, well, are you open to changing your mind about them? No, I'm not. I'm not. Mm-hmm. So I said, what are you scared of then? Mm-hmm. What is the threat then? Mm-hmm. If what we're teaching here, just take the moral principles right. and run with them.
Right, right.
And he said, oh, I can do that. Mm-hmm. I can do that. So Amen. He sat down. And we kept going. Mm-hmm. Now, I knew that I needed to speak a little differently.
Yes.
Yes.
But guess what? At the end of those 5 days, and by the way, those 5 days are hard. We have exercise routines. We have all sorts of therapies, blue therapy, music therapy, garden therapy. And it depends, right? It depends on the person. We meet people where they are. But at the end of that program, mm-hmm. he pulls me aside again and says, where can I buy a Bible?
Oh,
what?
Praise the Lord. Where,
the mom calls me a few days later. She says, what have you done to my son?
So it's I was a little... a better version of himself.
I was concerned.
Yes.
You know, at first, I'm like, where is this going? And she says, well, I'd like to send you some pictures. And one of those pictures was of that young man sitting on his bed, reading his Bible.
Amen.
The other one, he was using a shovel Beautiful. To plant something in his garden.
Awesome.
The other one was mowing outside the grass, and another one vacuuming his room.
Wow.
5 years later, that young man came back.
Oh.
Not for himself, but to lead a relative of his
oh,
who was struggling with God. The same problem.
Yes.
Now, this young man was struggling with identity crisis.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
He was dealing with drugs. I mean, it was a very tough case. Mm-hmm. But in that second program where he came, mm-hmm. we went through the same material. You know, I modified it for him a little bit.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
But there's always appeals. And he said, mm-hmm. I said, do you want to go a step further? And he said, yes. He decided to get baptized.
Amen.
So now he's got his own ministry.
Amen.
We still are working to get that baptism going because I like to really get to the bottom line of why are we doing this and why, mm-hmm. what does this look like?
Right.
But he's already running his own ministry.
Amen.
He's an example, and that's why his relative was able to come.
Praise Amen. The Lord. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Now, is it just you two or you have other people helping you?
So, yeah, we're a nonprofit. Mm-hmm. We make our programs very affordable, and that means that my wife and I, we carry a lot of the work.
Yes.
But when we are with God, we are the majority.
Amen. Yes.
Now, Amen. When I was without my wife, mm-hmm. The Lord always sent volunteers, mm-hmm. female volunteers.
Yes.
So if a female lady would say, hey, I'd like to be in your program, I'd be like, sounds good. We'll go through the application process and all of that. She'd be concerned if it was only me. I said, no, there's a volunteer. So I would go after that, look at my list of volunteers, and I would say, Lord, which one?
Right.
And the Lord would say, call this one. Mm-hmm. I would say, hey, would you like to come? Yes, I'd like to come.
Wow.
Now, it's 10 days out of their busy week,
yes.
out of their busy
yes.
you know, work Life. Mm-hmm. schedule.
Take time for health. Taking time
but
for health.
But the Lord would do that. Right. So a lot of volunteers would sacrifice their vacation days to be with us.
All right,
Wonderful.
Guys, we can go on and on and with stories, but we have some stories on video. Mm. I think, do you think it's a good time to roll the video now?
Yeah, I think it's about, 5 minutes of testimonies, I believe.
Praise
okay.
God.
Well, I'm looking forward to it. I like what I've heard.
I know.
But, you know, it's good to hear other people. So
That's
let's
right.
go to that video now.
Hi, I'm Angelo Carmona, and I attended a five-day program at Choose Life Abundant with my cousin, and it just completely changed our lives. Beyond the physical benefits that we received in just 5 days, they don't even compare with the emotional and spiritual benefits we received. I found my passion for mental health. I now started a ministry and a business to help other young people. My cousin is in the process of being baptized and is receiving Bible studies from Rolando, the program director. I can't say enough about him. I love him. He has been a tremendous mentor and guide throughout this whole process. And the whole CLA team has been just amazing. I have so much love and gratitude in my heart towards all of them. So I just want to say thank you to all of you. And if you're looking for an experience that's going to transform you physically, emotionally, and spiritually, I wholeheartedly recommend Choose Life Abundant. Thank you so much.
Hi, my name is Carrie House. My husband David and I attended the Choose Life Abundant 10-day program in August, about 3 or 4 months ago. I just can't say enough good about that program. It was such a blessing to us. We just went, we'd done 7 years of elder care, and then it seemed like I had just been really involved in some things, taking care of everything else but myself. We just felt like we needed a boost in health. So we went there for that. And we received benefits really unexpected, more than what we came for. And my husband had a frozen shoulder, and the exercise program that he got on there helped that tremendously. And as for myself, I think I lost 9 pounds at the program, and then maybe 11 pounds since. Just got us on a really good track. And in terms of unexpected benefits, I can't really say, list what they are, but everybody has different needs, but somehow it was just what we needed, and I'd highly recommend it to anybody. I'm going to count that as some of the best money that we ever spent, and it's much less expensive than a lot of other places, a similar, really a beautiful setting there. Rolando and Emily are fantastic, and if you want a head start just to get a boost in your lifestyle, or even if you're dealing with something difficult, highly recommended by us. Okay.
Hi everyone, my name is Kevin Mendez. I've been Adventist my entire life and exposed to the health message for a long time. But sadly, I didn't adhere to it. I found myself extremely unhealthy. Having been exposed to all the health information throughout the years, I felt like I knew everything that I needed to know. I knew what I needed to do, but of course I never applied my knowledge. So I have no doubt in my mind that the Lord led me to Choose Life Abundant. And by God's grace and the amazing care provided by Rolando and Emily and all the attention they provided, I got back on track physically and spiritually. You know, I finished my 10-day program and I was renewed and inspired to get even closer to God, which is an amazing thing. Choose Life Abundant is a wonderful place. It's a wonderful ministry. And I recommend it to anyone looking for a lifestyle center that focuses on individual health and wholeness and who works with you meticulously to restore and strengthen your health, you know, through lifestyle education and hands-on application, which is what really worked for me. You know, I'm thankful to God for Rolando and Emily. I feel like I left that place having more siblings. I love them and I highly recommend this place. God bless you. And I hope this message finds you well.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Wonderful. Mm-hmm. Well, I heard words like highly recommend more than once. I heard less expensive, amazing care, also renewed, inspired, and said wonderful place. Mm-hmm. And there was more, but I jotted those down. And those are good recommendations and good testimonies. And you surely have some more, but we have limited time.
Yes.
But how do you manage this? I mean, it's a great challenge, but how do you manage?
I mean, we would give the glory to God. It's His provision. It's His faithfulness.
Amen.
It's His calling, and He's faithful to provide for our needs. And I can identify with what Kevin was saying just a couple of minutes ago, where he was saying, you know, I grew up with a lot of this knowledge, but I didn't apply it, right? I just thought, like, you know, I had it, but I know that for myself, coming into work with Rolando, I became more convicted of God's calling to each one of us for complete salvation, for complete healing. He wants to heal our bodies, our minds. And I know that that total healing will come some for some after Jesus comes back and takes us home and completes that process. And yet he wants our minds to be transformed here.
That's right.
Like
yes.
Now is the time to let him in. And I'm realizing that this is why we're here. And he's called each one of us to help each other experience knowing him in a way where we know his love and we receive his love and receive his Holy Spirit. And then we can share that with others.
Yes.
And he has promised to provide for us every step of the way,
Amen.
What we need for our healing, and to be able to give it to others.
Mm-hmm.
And so, you know, he's done that for us just as we've given up the jobs that we had before, and we're walking in faith, and we're saying, okay, Lord, how do we keep the lights on? How do we have food? And there's a lot of ways that he does that.
Amen.
I mean, I'm not a theologian by training. Mm-hmm. I do certainly love reading my Bible.
Yes.
And one of the things that has helped us a lot is the understanding that Jesus is the bridegroom.
Amen.
And the church is the bride.
Mm-hmm.
And when you fall in love with someone, you understand there's certain requirements for us, for a man to marry a woman. In the Bible, it tells us in Exodus 21, verse 10, I believe it says that a man that's married should provide for his woman food, raiment, and marital duty.
Mm-hmm.
Now, think about this. We are the bride.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And if we are faithful to Christ, who is the bridegroom, and he's the perfect one, he's the perfect husband, he will provide for us what?
Mm-hmm.
Food, raiment, and marital love.
Love, that's right.
And so now I can trust in him. One of the things that was hard for me in our work was, should I go fundraise? Because that's the business mindset.
Business mindset.
Should I go marketing?
Mm-hmm.
And so the Lord says, he showed me that he would provide for me to let him have the finances, to let him have the marketing, to let him have the fundraising.
Mm.
For me to stop looking outside of my relationship with him for other men to provide these things for us.
Mm-hmm.
And so that became a very, very exclusive relationship where I now share my needs with him. And I say, Lord, you know our needs. And he constantly answers those in ways that we cannot even express.
Amen.
Amen.
Absolutely. I mean, I could tell you loads of miracles.
Yes.
I'll just touch on one real brief one.
Mm-hmm.
We had a situation. Our house has also batteries, solar batteries and so forth. A lot of expensive equipment. One time our equipment failed.
Okay.
Now to replace these batteries is about $7,000.
Wow.
We don't have that.
Mm-hmm.
We're living by faith here. Absolutely by faith.
Yes.
We're given everything. And so now we're on the hook for that. And it happens a lot in our ministry. So somehow the Lord impressed someone to cover those batteries.
Praise
Amen.
God.
So they sent 7,000. But we tithe on everything.
Oh,
so let's tithe on that 15%.
Right.
Now we're under the amount of the batteries again.
That's right. Mm-hmm.
But the price is 7,000.
That's right.
So I'm thinking, Lord, you provided someone. You asked us to be faithful. And we're doing what we are supposed to do, return you, give you, this money belongs to you.
Right.
So I called the battery place and I said, how are things? And they say, well, look, we have good news for you. We decided to give you a special discount.
Praise the Lord.
And it was, the discount was exactly the amount of the tithe
15%.
And offerings that we have given.
Wow.
Praise the Lord.
So we were still able to get this. And that happens over and over in our work. Now it takes patience.
Yes.
And you don't get it tomorrow.
That's
it might
right.
take 8 months.
That's time.
Praise
but
him
God
in the
answers.
Waiting.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah.
God
Amen.
Answers.
Amen. Amen.
Well, the Lord worries about every detail in our lives, and he always pulls through for us, come through, and we just have to acknowledge, you know, what he has done for us.
Yes. Yeah.
So you have seen the Lord do miracles, transform lives. Mm-hmm. It must be encouraging to you. How do you feel after people went through the program and they get back to you and say, hey, I feel good, you know, how do you feel?
Oh, it just raises up our faith and it fuels us to do it again and again. Because I'm telling you, whatever satisfactions that I was able to find in the world through sport, through accomplishments, they don't even pale I mean, the way that God rewards the heart.
Amen.
And the reward is Him in His presence with you.
That's right.
It's just an amazing experience.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Well, it's definitely very encouraging. In the days that we're living, we see a lot of needs, emotional needs, instability in the young and in the old, middle age. So praise the Lord for centers like yours. Choose Life Abundant, and we're going to share the contact information so you will be encouraged.
Really quick here,
yes.
Lawrenceburg, Tennessee. Can you give us some idea of where that is?
2 hours south of Nashville.
Okay.
1 hour 45 north from Huntsville.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Oakwood University is very close to us.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. Very good, very good.
3 hours and 30 from Chattanooga and 3 hours from Memphis.
Just a quick question. Do you do like chats or seminars at churches?
Yes, we do.
Oh, you do?
Yes, we do. Yep.
Wonderful. I'm glad I asked that question. So our viewers will take a picture of your contact information and they can contact you and invite you to their community.
Thank you.
It's wonderful.
The time has come to share the contact information for Life Abundant Ministry Sanitarium. And we would like to encourage you to jot it down, or as Idalia said, take a picture of it so that you can have the time to write it down.
That's right.
And so after you hear the contact information, you will then hear a news break from 3ABN, good news, and then we will be back for final comments from our guests, Rolando and Emily. So we will see you in just a moment.
If you would like more information about Choose Life Abundant, you can contact them at 399 Levi Hollow Road, Lawrenceburg, Tennessee, 38464. You can call them at 931-300-2925. That's 931-300-2925. They're online at ChooseLifeAbundant.org, or you can email them at info@ChooseLifeAbundant.org.
Praise the Lord. Thank you. Mm-hmm. Well, we have Rolando and Emily, and we'd like to know if you have any final comments.
Emily?
Thank you. I would just like to say thank you all for spending this time with us.
Amen.
And it's a privilege and a pleasure to serve God and to serve you. And we're just very thankful for that.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah, we want to praise the Lord for what He has been doing in our ministry. And I want to encourage everyone. The calling is for all of us to be ministers.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And it's up to us to experience a life that's filled with abundant peace and joy from the Lord. Even though there's trials, we can navigate through those with God's peace. And there's no better thing than being in the presence of God, hearing His guidance in your life. There is an experience of faith that you will never see when we are not at work in His work. Mm-hmm. I encourage everyone to take that step. Believe me, when I took it, I regret not doing this earlier in my life.
Wow.
So, yep.
Thank you so much.
A time as this.
Be brave.
Amen. Mm-hmm. Well, you have heard, and most of you have seen, Life Abundant Ministry and the marvelous things that God is doing through this ministry, Rolando and Emily, at the present time. And so we want to encourage you to pray for them.
Yes.
And we also encourage you to visit the website, take a look at what's there, and learn more. But don't stop there. Give them a phone call, ask questions, and they will be happy to give you answers. And you may want to start with a 5-day, but if you are brave, go ahead and the 10-day. Actually, the 10-day is the more recommended one.
That's right.
You have limited time. Start with the 5-day. You'll want to come back for the 10-day.
Amen. Yes? Amen. Just do it.
That's right. Well, thank you for being with us. God bless you. We'll see you next time on 3ABN today.
Amen.